Hi, I'm Keri. I'm here at Burlington County Prison Museum. I'm here with Marisa Bozarth, the museum coordinator, and she's going to go over with us the activity that's been going on here in the past couple of years. So, have there been any odors reported associated with the activity, perfumes or anything, smoke?
A few people have reported smelling cigarette smoke, cigar smoke, pipe tobacco, things like that coming out of the warden's office. I personally haven't ever experienced it, but I've had some visitors to the museum say that they were able to smell it.
Visitors mm-hmm. smelled it?
Yes.
Any workers or any other museum coordinators?
No.
How often was that, do you know?
I'd say maybe 3 or 4 times in 2 years. It wasn't that often.
What types of sounds have been heard in here?
Oh, gosh. We've heard footsteps, high heels. Probably the strangest thing that I've ever heard. Every once in a while you hear like the iron door hitting off of a wall as if like somebody's trying to get out of the ones that are padlocked. It's not very loud, but everything echoes so you can pick that up. We've heard shuffling feet as if somebody is shackled. People have heard voices every once in a while.
With those voices, do you know what they were saying?
No. No. It was very muffled, and I've heard a voice on 2 occasions, and it was loud, but it wasn't very distinct. You can't really understand words. When I heard it, it sounded like a young child trying to talk, but it was like they were talking normal, but in here it's loud because of the echoes and everything like that. It didn't sound like they were really whispering or upset or anything like that. It was just like regular talking.
Now, you heard a young child, or...
Mm-hmm.
So you heard a young child?
Yes.
Okay. Has there ever been any movement of objects?
Not while I've been here. When they first started renovating, I've heard that when the men were in working, they've had objects move, like their tools, they'd go to lunch or leave for the end of the day, and they'd come back and couldn't find their tools, and they'd be in a cell that was supposedly locked. That was the first time they ever brought a ghost research group in to actually look into anything because it was scaring them enough that they really didn't want to come back to work. So
you're saying the tools would be moved into a locked cell?
Yeah.
And they had no idea how that got in?
No.
To your knowledge, do you know if there's ever been any problems with electrical appliances, such as the lights flickering and things turning on and off by themselves?
We've had the lights go on and off. It's pretty often that the lights will flicker. If you walk into certain rooms, the light will flicker, and then when you go to leave that room, it'll flicker, but the whole time you're in it, it doesn't do anything. And we've had experiences where one row of lights would go out and come back on, and then another row would do it, and then another row. When, with our electricity, if you hit one switch, mm-hmm. everything goes off, every electrical outlet, every light, everything. So there's no possible way that it should happen.
Okay. Do you know if there's ever been any plumbing problems, like water leaking in strange places for no reason?
The only thing I know of is about maybe a year or two ago, I'm not 100% sure exactly when, they found a footprint on the floor, a wet footprint, up in the bathroom on the 3rd floor, and there's no running water up there, and there is in other spots of the building, but it's been cut off to that floor.
And how long ago was that?
About a year or two ago.
And there's only one?
Yeah.
Do you know if anybody's ever been physically touched or attacked?
We've had people be touched, nothing major. We had one of our volunteers he says he was poked in the back. Not forcefully, but just enough, like if somebody tapped you on the shoulder type of thing. And another research group that came in, a woman claims that she was pushed down the steps. I wasn't here that evening. I've just heard about it.
And when you say you were touched on your back, did you feel any, at the time, did you maybe feel a cold? Or did you feel hot or even emotion?
Not really. It was really weird because I was just sitting there. And the day before we were going through with our own like voice recorders and I just sent them up to see if anything happened. And talking, just being weird, you know, saying, if anybody's here, please say something on the recorder, and we didn't get anything. And we kept saying, if somebody's here, let us know. And I was just sitting there all by myself, and all of a sudden I heard shuffling behind me, and I went to turn around, and my chair's on wheels, and something hit me on the shoulder, like touched me on the shoulder, and I jumped, and the chair moved. Now, the chair probably moved because of me, but it was just, and it was weird because I felt like somebody was behind me. And then all of a sudden something touched me, and then I just walked out the door and stood out there for a while and calmed myself down and came back in.
So. Did you feel like they were attacking you, as if
no.
It was an angry touch, or they were just
I've never
letting
felt
you know they
like
were there.
Anything was angry or mad or anything. It just seems like they want you to know that they're in the building type of thing.
Do you know if there's ever been any sightings or shadows or vapors or mists?
I know some of the other research groups have seen apparition type things. I don't know exactly what they were. I've seen shadows twice in two different spots, one in the basement running up the steps, and one was in the gift shop, walked out of the warden's office and went towards the back door.
And you said mm-hmm. You saw two shadows?
Yes.
Do you know what the shadows, do they come with a figure or?
They looked similar to your shadow standing upright and walking. You could tell it was a person, but you couldn't see like facial features or anything like that, but you could see like legs and arms moving.
Okay, and where were they walking?
One was in the basement coming up the steps, moving really quickly, and the other one was came out of the warden's office and went down towards the steps in the gift shop, towards the back door more.
So he left
it
out of this
that
room?
Way. Yes.
You saw him in this room?
Well, I saw it come like through the doorway because I was in the gift shop. So.
Okay. To your knowledge, do you know if there's ever been any strange activity on this property?
Such as, what do you mean by strange?
Well, what they used to hang people?
Yes.
So
we hung seven people out in the courtyard. Two were hung on a hanging tree, but they were held in the building, so they spent their last nights here. And we know for a fact that one of those people is buried in the courtyard.
Okay. Well, that's it. I wanted to thank Marisa. Thank you very much for inviting us to the historical Burlington County Prison Museum and giving us your time and answering our questions. I'd like to wish you a lovely evening.
Thank you.
You're welcome. And thank you.